Hey there, you're tuned in to MEA Worldwide. I'm your host, Elena Jordan, and today we are at Paley Fest checking out the upcoming series, Dollface, that's going to premiere on Hulu in November. We're going to talk to the cast and the crew, so be sure to stay tuned. So I am here with Brenda Song, who plays Madison.
Yes, ma'am.
Tell me a little bit about your character on this show and how she maybe differs from some things that we've seen you in the past.
Well, Madison plays Jules' best friend and college roommate, and when Jules sort of tries to integrate herself back into her friend group, she is the one that's least likely to let Jules back in because she is the most hurt. Her walls are up very, very high, and throughout the course of the season, you see them come down, you see a softer side of her, but also that she's harboring her own secrets. So it's really fun. The arc of the girls' friendship on this show is, I think, what really drives it. And I think Madison is so great because she is so dry. She is a go-getter, very, very, like, facetious. She's, like, very serious. She's not one to, like, joke around. She takes everything very, very seriously. She's, like, the mama of the group. She's the one that will, like, pack everyone's lunches, make sure everyone's on time, plan the trip. That's her.
So do you feel like, you know, I know a lot of people know you from Suite Life.
Yeah, oh, polar opposite. Yeah, exactly. She's like the polar opposite.
But do you think that maybe having that Disney Channel background helped with kind of the tone aspects of the show? Are there some more like absurdist things a little bit?
It's very different doing a sitcom and a single cam comedy is very different. But the thing about, you know, working on Suite Life, which was amazing, is just that it allowed me to play and explore to see, you know, how far I'm willing to go. And that's always great because that gives you the skills to be able to not be afraid to do whatever on whatever set.
We are here with Kat Dennings, who plays Jules, the lead character of Dollface. You're the Dollface of Dollface.
I guess, you know, if you want to put a label on it.
No, of course you were phenomenal in Two Broke Girls. Absolutely loved the show. This is your big return to TV, and I know that you were kind of in talks to do an ABC pilot and then kind of always had this one on the back burner. What is it about this show in particular that made this your big triumphant return?
Oh, I love the... thank you. I really connect with the story of the character, my character anyway. She starts out really in love with her boyfriend of 5 years, and he breaks up with her out of nowhere, and it destroys her. And she has to find her friends again, which she's kind of left by the wayside, which I haven't exactly done, but I've been through this emotionally. So I think it's really interesting to show that.
Now, this show, too, was created, of course, by another phenomenal female and is really driven about, you know, the female dynamic. But coming from the creator of Harley Quinn, and you, of course, known for Thor, are there any superheroes that would be your dream superhero to play on character on film?
We're keeping it in the Marvel universe or just anybody?
Marvel or DC. I mean, Harley's DC, so it's like we can cross.
Okay. How about...
I have to keep you on your toes.
Wolverine? Yes, queen.
Yes, I would love that. Oh!
I'm halfway there.
I think we need that. We need a female Wolverine. Hi there, we are here with Esther Povitsky. It's hard for me to say your last name because I always call you Little Esther because I know you from stand-up.
Yes, so. Yeah, that's totally fair. Little Esther, Esther Povitsky, they both work.
So kind of going from your stand-up background into this show, I mean, of course, we loved you in Crazy Ex-Girlfriend.
Thank you.
You were phenomenal as Maya, one of my favorite characters.
Oh, thank you.
But then going into now kind of a similar show in that it has this really positive female-driven energy and that it has some elements of absurdist comedy. Do you feel that your comedy background helped you?
100%, yeah. And I feel like this character, Izzy, is very similar to Maya in the sense that they're both losers, desperate to be accepted. And they're both Jewish, half regular. And they're both...
half regular?
And, so I think maybe there'll be even more similarities as we go on. But, I do feel like doing stand-up and acting, they both kind of help each other. They're kind of cross-training for one another, so.
And this show is really focusing on this female dynamic, the energy of female friends. And you have really kind of pioneered some things as well. You were the very first female guest on the Joe Rogan show.
True.
And, you know, so do you feel that this is a unique experience for you just being on set? Or how does this kind of relate to other projects that you've worked on?
It's definitely my happy place. Dollface. You know, I feel like on my last show, it was just me and one guy, and I felt like I dreamt of the day when I would get to be on a show with all women and like such fabulous women. I feel like I really lucked out. I feel like they're all my big sisters, even though we're all the same age. They're my big sisters because they are more experienced and know more than me and have so much to teach me.
I have to say, though, you're pretty accomplished yourself. You created your own show, Alone Together.
True. 2 seasons on Hulu. Check them out.
Yeah. Hi there. We are here with Jordan Weiss, who created Dollface, coming to Hulu. Now, you've worked on some amazing production. I'm so excited about Harley Quinn. I cannot wait.
Yes. That was my first TV writing job. I love Pat and Justin, the creators, and it's super exciting. It's so different from this, but also weirdly very similar because Harley is going through a breakup from the Joker, and so it was sort of funny working on that right before Dollface because, like, this is still a girl and her best friend going through a breakup, Harley and Poison Ivy.
So how important is it, do you think, especially in the current climate, to create these female-driven shows that also show the importance of these female friendships that maybe have not been explored as much in some media previous?
I think it's so important. I think a lot of girls and women feel like if I don't have a romantic love story, if I don't have, you know, the Notebook happening in my life, I'm unfulfilled. And I think that's because there's a million love songs and movies and television shows that are dedicated to that. And so I would love to just do something that goes into a platonic female friendship with that level of detail, because maybe the greatest love story of your life is with your best friend, and that's okay.
I absolutely love that. So what was kind of the inspiration for this, and did you seek out your best friends to kind of give you a little bit of inspiration as well?
It's definitely autobiographical from many aspects, though. Like, I think I've been a Jules, I think I've been a Madison. I've been on both ends of it. But yeah, I think I could have taken my college years to put myself out there more than I did. And I think coming out of that experience, I made a really conscious effort, went through a breakup to reconnect with my girlfriends. And I really did live a lot of the show. So that's that's my answer.
We had an amazing time talking to the cast and the crew of the upcoming series Dollface. Be sure to check it out when it hits Hulu in November. And be sure to tune back in here to MEA Worldwide for more exclusive content, interview, and more. See you guys next time.